So I've been looking around and like trying to like mess around with the like scrap and stuff. And I found you can like clear the entire plots and stuff. And I've even built some stuff as well. Look, I built this. I actually built some more crops as well. But I built this. It's not very much, but it's a start. Yeah. First kind of house. It's pretty easy to do as well. I'm just going to go through it briefly, like what I did. I could even, like, plant even more tapio plants. Which is awesome. But yeah, it's pretty simple. I mean, almost anyone, even an idiot like me, can work it out. That you can just go along and you get the scrap option. So I'm like, oh, 10 steel. Thank you very much. I got 10 steel. I got steel. Yeah. So use the steel to make things with, basically. It's got a structures. I like metal for some reason. I don't know why. Probably won't last as long, but yeah. You can have prefabs. Various designs of prefabricated buildings. Which are pretty cool. And providing you got the room, you can stick them on, you know? Like, I'm not sure how this would fit, but if you wanted it to fit, you could probably get it to work. Maybe something like this, I don't know. I think put it on the end. I guess I would, like, maybe put that on to make a complete house. I don't know how it's going to fit together, but you know, if you mess around with enough, you get it to fit. Or whatever. Or you could just put, like, a wall on it. Like, I might just go ahead. And, of course, you got roofs as well. These are all the walls you can have. Isn't that pretty cool? I do like the, you have several walls to choose from. They all look pretty rough. I'm not gonna lie, they all seem pretty rough and ragged. As you might expect. This one doesn't fit. So, trying to find something that fits this wall. It's not happening. It's not. You can tell because it kind of snaps into place. But for some reason, it doesn't want me to put a wall here. Maybe it'll accept a door. Maybe. No. Okay, so these prefabs, if you put two together, you're kind of screwed then. I mean, I guess I could just put it in front, kind of, in an ugly way, like that. There you go. There you go. You can kind of see in, but hey, you got another doorway. But anyway, enough of that. Looks like the crops are doing nicely. I didn't know that someone just automatically assigns themselves to the crops. So that's great, because I was like, how do you do that? But apparently it happens automatically. So anyway, let's just make sure I've transferred everything. No, no. Yes, exit, please. Enter to exit, yes. Not really that full. I don't think. Let's transfer all our crap. Because I don't know if I carry around that steel or whether it gets... I think it just, like, when you scrap stuff, it automatically gets added. But I'm gonna like, kind of store my junk. Okay. Now, I kind of messed up on the last episode by selling my food. Because you can cook it. And cooking removes the radiation. I know that logic is kind of screwed, but... oh, we don't have a teleport to the gas... Oh, yeah, we do. The truck stop. I saw a cooking device by the truck stop and by the bluff. So, and I heard that cooking removes the radiation. So all that food, and food is very good in Fallout 4. So all that food I sold... That was idiotic. I should not have done that. I had no idea. Because in Fallout 3, food was kind of worthless. With all that radiation and stuff. You find something? What do you find? Well, I already know about that. I'm not going to make my base here, though. Because it's a bit remote. But yeah, where did I see it now? So, yeah, here, look. There is a cooking station. And we can make like a beverage with some purified water. A roast. We can make some soup. We can make all kinds of stuff. No, I'm not. I don't really have anything that we can cook right now. Oh, I've got mud chops. I can make mud chops. Which don't have any radiation. Sweet. And you get XP for it as well. So, I'm going to see if I can buy back my food or something. Or like trade for it. Maybe get it back. Who knows? But yeah. That was pretty dumb of me to sell that stuff. Because I thought it was all irradiated. And it was like the old Fallout where you were kind of... I mean, you've always been able to remove the irradiation. But I never bothered before. And maybe I shouldn't bother now. But it's kind of irks me a little bit that I did that. That I was kind of that dumb. To get rid of all that lovely food. And it didn't... I don't know how much it costs to get back, so maybe I won't even bother, actually. Maybe we'll just collect what we get from now on. And learn, lesson learned, you know? I think that's probably the best idea, because I think if I buy it back, I'm going to pay much more than I got for it. And to be fair, we needed to get Jet for Mama. And you can, like, not give stuff to Mama and be a good guy. And I am playing a good guy, but not that good, you know? I'm just going to check how much it would be to buy it back. Where did she go? She's not even here anymore. Okay. I'll just take this stuff then. Where did she go? She just, like, upped and left. I thought she'd be here for a while. It seems not. Okay. So she's gone anyway, so... Lesson learned, yeah? Okay, so she's gone. And our current objectives are... Let's see. Kill the raiders at Corvega Assembly Plant. That's our current mission. The one I want to do. And that's quite far away. I mean, it's kind of equally far from there. So I'm just going to head down south on this road and we'll see what happens. See what we meet along the way. Because it's kind of dark. It's nighttime. So we could bump into anything. Have we checked this area out? I'm not sure if we checked this out. It's the thicket excavations. This looks intriguing. Let's see if we can find anything useful. Anything in here? Not really, is the answer. It's kind of basic. Yes. Anything in the cars? I don't know if they ever stash anything in the cars. Okay, this leads on to the quarry. I'm hoping there's no death claws here. Sully Mathis. Ah, who's that fella? Let's go say hello. Hello there, excuse friend.
Me. Looking to earn some caps? I could use a hand here if you're all done gawking, you know.
I'm just glad your quarry's not infested with death claws, to be honest, mate. Ask for money, okay? Help with what, friend?
Help you with what, exactly? I'm trying to fix this old water pump. Should be plenty of scrap in here. If I can get it drained out.
Hmm.
What do you need help with? The pump isn't in top shape, but it should at least start. There must be some leaky connections flooding me out. Think you could fix them? The leaks will be underwater. Look for bubbles, and you should find them.
Okay, man. So... Oh. Oh, is it dangerous? Is it dangerous? That's the question. Am I getting any readings, but... From the vats? But there could be bad guys in this water. I don't know. Do we need to select the quest, because sometimes it doesn't do it. Yeah. Okay, repair the pipes. I presume it's in here. I presume the water is irradiated. So. Yep, 10 rads. Ooh, 10 rads. That's a lot of rads. Okay. Do we have any stuff to help with that? Let me put that on. Not really, we don't have a lot to deal with radiation. We do have some rad X, rad resistance. So let's give that a shot. I can't see anything. There's only one rad underneath. Whew. Okay, he said look for the bubbles, so I'm gonna follow the bubbles down and see if we can't fix this. Okay, that's one. Just keep an eye on them rats. Okay, where's the other bubbles? I think there's some bubbles there, I'm not sure. There's another one, look. Okay, one more pipe. This feels incredibly risky, though. Okay, there's another one. Somewhere. Where's the bubbles? Can't see the bubbles. There they are. Come on. Okay. Let's get the frick out of this dodgy water. Shall we die? I don't know if there was any shark in there. The dog seems to like it in there.
Dog meat! Over here.
Dark meat seems to be quite happy there, so.
Move here. Here.
Okay, dog meat, you just chill out there, buddy.
Excuse me.
That's a ticket. You do the honors. Hit that switch on the end of the pump.
Wait a second. Did you hear
sounds
that?
Good.
Let's do this.
Whoa. Trying to aim for the face. Crit. Thank you very much.
Maybe if I close off this intake, I can get enough pressure.
Oh, there's another one. Oh, you suck.
Guess my good karma's paying off.
Whew. Took a lot of bullets.
Ah, there it is.
Hey there.
Meyer looks. I guess I shouldn't be surprised that stirred him up. Anyway, I still got some tinkering to do on this thing. Shouldn't be too hard now, though. Thanks for pitching in.
Here's
a little something before you clear out.
Thanks, man. Pull the plug. Well, it was worth it for the XP, but not really worth it for the payoff. Pretty much. Yeah, let's see if we can make something. Can we? Yeah, we can make some red roach. I still had a bunch of meat, look. Sweet. Iguana steak, yeah. What else can we make? Roasted myelurk meat. Oh god. But yeah, that scared the crap out of me, those myelurks. I was not expecting that. We can make Nuka Cola. Oh, Dirty Wastelander, nice. That'd be nice to make. Someone done a bunch of cooking there. I'm gonna switch back to my hard hat for out in the wastelands. Just because the other thing looks a bit, well, it covers my face basically. Ooh, caps. Are we allowed these? I hope we are. Hope we're not, like, gonna offend him. Yeah.
Sweet.
Sweet. Yeah, I hope we're not stealing from this poor fella. It doesn't make any suggestion that we would be stealing it, so it's not red. And look, it's not red. So I just feel bad for, because it's in close proximity, but you know, you'd think there'd be something to say like, this is this dude's stuff, you shouldn't touch it. It's so close.
Yes.
Nice. Let's see what's going on with this terminal. Shipment log. Tables and tops, pillars and pushes, interior slabs. Kind of boring stuff. Play tape. Sully's log. This is a great spot with the right crew. I'd have no problem keeping this place locked down. Traders run close enough for easy pickings. But not so close that we'd end up skinned. Whole damn thing is filled with water, though. Figures, there's always a catch. Big-ass drainage pump looks mostly... So he's after traders? He's a bandit? If I'm lucky, it might still work. I'd like to take a closer look tomorrow. Son of a gun. Nope, not gonna be easy. Still, pump is in better shape than you think. I'd like to head back and grab some tools before but it's pretty late. I'll tinker with it some more before I go to bed tonight and then head out tomorrow. Next. It shouldn't be too hard now. Glad I grabbed the sledge. Even though that bitch would carry you all this way. Thing was rusted tight. With a few good whacks of the sledge, cleared out the problem right up. Thing made the damnedest of sound each time, though. You'd swear something was not moving around in there. Yes, something was moving around in there. I was able to make the most of connections, patch it up, and pipe leaks as good as I can. Besides, one's in the water. All the noises I've been hearing, I'm not setting foot in there. Probably head back and drag one of the new guys over here and make him do it. Yeah. So, that was Sully's log, huh? Shall we confront about this? Let's take that, because we need some electronic stuff. Is that everything? I wonder where he went. Is he in here? Where'd he go? It was just there. Ah, there you are. Sully.
What if I redirect the flow through here? Excuse me. Do you mind? I'm busy here. Do you mind? I'm busy here.
Still, no further options. So, I guess we helped a bad guy unwittingly. Uh-huh. And now we need to decide whether to kill him or not, or stop him or not. We can't talk to him, so. Well, that's unfortunate. That was not our intention. Ah, well, just goes to show you should check someone out before you help them. I wouldn't have him pegged for a bad guy, but apparently he was. So, anyway, we're going to head down and clear out the bandits next at the Korvega assembly plant. And... is that... that's not a road. It says there's a road. But... who's this? Oh, it's schools! Ah! Ha ha! Hi, guys. Shit. What do we do? We need to do something. Need some weapons. Still got my minigun. Still got Molotov cocktails. Okay. I need to select it, I think. What button was it? Okay. Let's put it on our favorites. Number four. Oh god. That didn't work. You're supposed to throw the grenade with the alternative button. Nope, that didn't work. Okay. Let's see. Oh god, they're catching up. This isn't good. Nah, it doesn't... that's really dumb. It doesn't want to throw it. Why don't you want to throw the Molotov? What is the problem? Maybe if I don't equip anything? This is ridiculous. Come on, throw it. There we go. Okay, that took long enough. Okay, he's burning. There we go. Yeah, I don't get why it didn't work. I was holding, like, I was pressing. I guess you got to tap the alt button or something. Let's test it again. Let's even get it working right. It didn't hurt us too bad. Hello. Get off. There we go. You gotta hold it down a bit. Watch out, doggy. Getting a bit crisp there, mate. Subway token. Alright, so I won't panic next time. I'll just like... I think you hold it down. But yeah, it's kind of dumb. Maybe I'll remap that to another key. Got 3 10-milli pistols now. Okay. I'm gonna just deal with this radiation. Let's get some right away. And eat some mud chops. Sword. Let's just see what they were doing here. Oh man, looks like they killed someone. Yeah, gunner's camo bandana. It's a damn shame. Ghoul's gonna kill someone. I got a military cap. I wonder if that's any good. Let's put it on. Let's see. Oh, it gives perception. Sweet. Okay, enough of that. So, I was just saying before we got attacked that there's not much of a road. You know, I'm looking for a road, but I don't see one. Or path, even. I don't see much of anything. Where's the path gone? So like, over here? Ah, here we are. I found it. Yeah, I was like, it's got to be close. And here it is. Let's keep our wits about us. I wonder if I can get rid of any more of this radiation. I got a ton doing that job. Oh, I'm using Rad X. Oh, stupid. Yeah, I had it like one click away. Oh, stupid. So dumb. Never mind. I'll get some more. It's just annoying to waste stuff, but I should have looked where it was. I just like, it's nearby. I leveled up as well, so I really should trying to find some stuff I cooked. Rad's 11. You have to be really careful what you click on. Otherwise you might click on something that gives you radiation. Or waste something. Anyway, I'm gonna level up. Because we leveled up. Now you guys have noticed I'm like pretty much pimping out my stats. I'm not doing perks. The reason for that is like persuasion is dependent on charisma. You know, these matter a lot. These, you know, strength, perception. Perception not so much because I don't like using bats that much. Endurance is good because you can run away for longer. Yeah, but charisma helps your persuasion out a lot. And prices are better when you barter, so. Intelligence has an effect on a number of experience points earned. So that is very important. So that's why I'm kind of maxing these out. Well, not maxing them out, but I'm going to get them to a decent level first. And then I'm going to go on to the perks that are below. I should have made that clear at the start. So I'm sorry I didn't explain my intentions. Because obviously that might be a bit frustrating if you know. So why isn't he getting any perks? Why is he only investing in stats? Because stats are important. And I know what I'm doing. I did some research. And I've played these games before, so I know that some things aren't very self-evident. Starlight Drive-In. I suspect it's full of mole rats or bad guys. Who's that? Is that a bad guy? Is that ghoul? It's hard to tell. Nope. Oh, hello. Pretty bad shot when in that, sadly. Whoa. Whoa. The teleporting. Hoo-hoo. Lovely mole rat. So that was a decoy. I don't want to get too close to the water. It's giving me rads. But yeah, that was just a dummy. I thought that was a person there. It fooled me. I was completely fooled. I'm so gullible. It sounds like a trap. It was a trap. Let's see.
How you doing, buddy?
Hey, boy. Think you can find something for me? See if there's any good stuff nearby, boy.
See if there's anything worth a damn. I didn't find anything. Okay. This place might be booby-trapped, so gotta be careful. Okay. We had some Radex on when we went near that pond, so it served a purpose. Nuka-Cola. Doesn't look like there's anything that great in here. Bit of music. Shit! No! Oh, I should have seen that coming. I don't think I saved either. Oh, that was lame. That was so dumb. Oh well. Let's see if we can do that better this time. At least we're not too far away. I had a feeling there'd be another booby trap. I just didn't expect it to like explode behind me. Wow. Okay, let's see if we can do a better job now. We know there's a trap behind the door. And we know there's mole rats over there. Okay. Okay. But I totally didn't see that. So where's the explosive? Gotta keep an eye out. Gonna save it here just in case it explode again. Okay. That is so well hidden. I don't see it at all. Where's the tripwire? Was it a landmine I stood on? Yeah, I'm really paranoid now. It's like, where is it? Where's the explosive? I don't know where it is. That's strange. I don't know if I want to go in here now. Maybe go upstairs if we can. I don't see anything on the stairs, so. There's nothing there. Damn, this is scary, because any minute you could get blown up. Okay, dog meat went in okay. Let's take a look around. I don't see anything. There's nothing. No trip wires. Just checking to see if like there was anything here, but it doesn't look like it. Okay, so there's no trip wires or anything here. But there seems to be one in here because it blew me up. Where is it? Can we move something there? I'm just really curious where it is. I want to know. Seeing if it sets anything off. Maybe we can look in through here. Get a better view. What is that? Is that what it was? Oh, we've triggered the... triggered the mole rats. How many shots does this thing take? Trying to loot. There's probably some loot around here, but I'm like really curious to see if it's booby trapped. I want to know what that thing is. Where's it going? That thing. Was it that blew me up? Damn it, I'm so curious now. I want to know what killed me. Was it that? Can't be that, surely. Can I jump up on this? No? Oh, yes, I can. Okay. Oh. What? See, you can get on here, but you can't crawl through. What is that? Ah. So weird, I can't find... I think it was that blew me up. Or is that just a Nuka-Cola? I don't know what that is. So I'm going to save it. And if we die, we die, you know? So, where is it? Okay, I got the cola, whatever that was. I thought it was a Nuka-Cola. Then we got, like, this thing. It's nothing. It's got to be underneath this, these leaves. Potato chips. I don't see it at all. But there must be something under this. It's so weird. We may never know where the explosive was. If you know, let me know in the comments below. I don't dare search anymore. I think it was under the leaves, but it seemed to come from behind me because I got out of there. Yeah. Lovely sound. Anyway, enough messing around. We found a new place at the Starlight Drive-In. Next up, we're going to head over to the Corvega Assembly. We got a bit of a detour there, but next episode we'll be checking out the assembly plant and see if we can clear the radius from there. See you then, guys.